in a world full of orphans.
Oh.
They still had each other.
Yep, there it is. There's our final monologue from The Leftovers.
I didn't know
that's how the show was going to end.
I didn't.
I was not warned. Nope. I was not consulted. Not that I wanted to be consulted. I was, you know, I come from the theater where there's a lot of respect for writers, for the authors of a play, for the playwright. And so I never got in the way of the writing. I come to find out later that a lot of actors were always emailing and talking to Damon about where the storyline was going. And I didn't even know that you could do that. So
we had Justin on the couch and showed him this very scene.
Uh-huh.
And he believes Nora was lying.
Mm-hmm.
What's your theory?
I've always said that I'll never tell.
Wait, so do you have a theory and you won't tell me, your old friend that you've known for years? Or do you not have a theory?
I know what I believed when I was delivering it. And I'll tell you that whether Nora was lying or telling the truth, it doesn't matter. It wouldn't necessarily change the performance. The only thing it would change would that it might dissuade someone who thinks the opposite of me into thinking another way about the piece. And I think that robs the piece of its power. Because okay. What it does is that it reveals to you something about the way you see the world. If you think she's lying or telling the truth. And I don't want to rob anyone of that experience, because I think the most powerful aspect of The Leftovers was its ambiguity.
That's
so
true.
I, as Nora, I just don't feel like I want to take anybody's perspective away. Even yours.